is a bright golden haze on the meadow. There's a bright golden haze on the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way.
I think the musical is an American form.
Yes.
I mean, they're sort of invented it, and they're kind of best at it in terms of... I noticed that because I'd done cabaret in London, and then a few years later I came to do it here, and especially actually with things like the dancers and the people, you know, like just are boom, they've got it, and they're so much better trained and much more kind of...
It's almost like it's in their bones, isn't
it? Yeah, and I guess also here, you know, it comes to this town to try and be in those shows. You have to be shit hot to get those jobs.
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Why choose that particular song?
Well, I didn't initially, and it just kept coming up in my head. I remember I was driving around Sydney and I'd keep singing it, you know, just the first refrain. I thought, well, maybe I should do it live, and if we tour this and this album does well and I do it live, I might start with that song. And then I thought about Oklahoma as a piece and how important that was to Broadway and how I really wasn't doing anything that was pre-Oklahoma. So I thought, look, why don't we just make that the landmark and the beginning of the album and the start of modern Broadway.
I think everybody acknowledges that Rodgers and Hammerstein really were the people who founded the modern musical as we know it. They were the ones who gathered their own talents, their own innovations, and everybody else's, and put them all together into a musical that ended up being Oklahoma.
Yeah,
which
just sort of restructured the whole face of musicals, really.
Yeah, I mean, it was the first musical where every single element played off every other element. Rodgers himself said once, the orchestrations sounded the way the costumes looked.
Yeah.
And the dance was a psychological reflection of what was going on with the characters. And you know, up until that point, there tended to be a collection of great songs where the plotting was a little clumsy and people would tend to sort of come downstage and do a good song and then step back up into the show.
Yeah, but they stand out and sing.
Right, yeah. Right. But Oklahoma was the one where
the characters and the stories progressed through the song. And that's been, you know, obviously changed, and you know, we see that most famously with someone like Stephen Sondheim, where, you know, that it's literally, it's all seamless. Or something like Les Miserables, where you sing the whole show through.
Oh, what a beautiful...